sources are now telling CNN the FBI has uncovered evidence that criminal hackers have infiltrated state election databases both in Arizona and Illinois, potentially exposing the personal information of hundreds of thousands of voters. Investigators say what they're likely after is names. They want the addresses, the driver's license, partial social security numbers. A law enforcement official saying the top suspects are most likely based overseas. And that attack comes on the heels of the suspected Russian hack of the Democratic National Committee's email system. So joining me now, Rob Sadowski, director at Technology Solutions for RSA, a cybersecurity firm. And Jim Sciutto is with us from Washington, our CNN chief national security correspondent. So good to have both of you on. And Rob, let me just begin with you here, because I know voters' ears are perked when they hear, you know, the hackers and stealing their personal information. I mean, the question is, how much of their personal information could have been compromised? And what about actual votes as well, which then leads to concerns about November 8th?
Right. So Brooke, I think what we're seeing here is that these databases are used by the states to maintain their voter registration records. So the type of information would be name, it would be their party affiliation, and other potentially their date of birth, and other information that the state would use to help them register to vote. And it may also have additional information like where they vote, their polling place, and some other additional information there. So this information is generally a matter of public record. So in and of itself, it's not necessarily that damaging when it gets out. But when you take this information and combine it with other information, because as we've seen, hackers and cyber criminals, what they'll often do is build profiles on individuals. And the more of a profile that they have, the more convincing they can be to commit fraud or other type of dangerous activity about this individual. So that's why they should be concerned.
Rob, last question to you. You know, in the sophistication level of the technology these days, that something could happen November 8th.
Well, I think that certainly we've seen through the hacks of the DNC and here that there are outside forces and outside actors that are definitely interested in influencing these type of proceedings. And I think we should expect to see continued attempts to compromise these type of systems. Now, you know, in terms of influencing votes, typically those systems are kept offline. There's checks and balances. There's good checks on the security. But I think Jim's point is very well taken, undermining the confidence in the system, that people don't feel that their data is safe, that they feel the integrity of the system is somehow compromised, can throw doubts into that, into the authenticity of some of the results potentially. I think that's really what we have to be concerned about and place more attention on monitoring for these type of attacks so that we can prevent them from happening and undermining some of this confidence.
Yep. Rob and Jim, thank you both so much.
Thanks a lot.